to the fourth verse. Exodus, the fourth chapter, to the second, to the fourth verse. It reads like this. And the Lord said unto him, what is that in thine hand? And he said, a rod. And he said, cast it on the ground. And he cast it on the ground, and it became a serpent. And Moses fled before it. And the Lord said unto Moses, put forth thine hand, and take it by the tail. And he put forth his hand and caught it, and became a rod in his hand. If I was to leave a subject today, it would be grab it by the tail. Grab it by the tail. I don't care what you're going through, what the problem is, what the situation is. If God tells you to reach down and grab it, you better reach down and grab it.
Amen.
No ends, and no buts. Reach down and grab it.
Amen.
We have children this morning that are expecting gifts on Christmas. Because that's what it's all about, giving gifts. But we don't realize the value of what it holds. All we think about is what we're going to receive. Sometimes we don't realize how special the gift is. All we worried about is the quality of the gift. We're not worried about how the person went out and got the gift and didn't think about not giving you a gift, but they went out to give you a gift.
They picked that,
or maybe they made it, or maybe they made up a card, or maybe they baked a cake, or they could have drew a picture, a portrait of you. Whatever thought is behind the gift, that's what's important.
That's right.
Not the gifts themselves, but
the thought
behind the gift.
Yeah.
Okay? He didn't realize how worthy the gift was. You know, sometimes children just going to be children. You know, if they don't get a bike and you give them a game, they're going to be mad and upset because they didn't get what they wanted.
Exactly. Come on.
And adults, they have tantrums too.
Uh-huh.
And tantrums too. If they don't get what they want, they sit somewhere in a corner or they sit somewhere in the house and they pout all 10 years.
Come on.
10 years.
They don't worry about. Children pout for like a minute. Then the next minute, they're over it.
That's right.
But adults pout 10 years.
Come on,
sometime until they die.
Come on, Bishop.
Because, you know, it turns into a reprobate mind.
Come on, Bishop.
It turns into stubbornness.
Oh.
The Bible says, old foolish Galatian, who has bewitched you that you not obey the truth? Galatians 3rd chapter. You don't bewitch yourself. You know, you don't give away your joy yourself. Ain't nobody stole it. You gave it away.
Come on.
How am I giving it away? By simply holding on to something that you can forgive for.
Amen.
Something that you can forget.
Amen.
Oh, it's hard to forget something. That's true. But it don't take you 10 years.
Wow. Amen.
No, it don't.
It takes you on your bending knees, begging the Lord for grace. Because grace will get you out of that. Grace is what will save you from all that misery.
Uh-huh. Yes, yes.
Hello?
Yes.
He was missing out on the point that God was trying to make, hallelujah, by using envy. Jealousy. When we think about some of the gifts that our sisters and brothers received on Christmas, and then we look at our gift and we say, I wanted that. I wanted that bike and he got a bike. I wanted that doll and she got a doll. Instead of you enjoying your gift that your parents went out and got you with their hard-earned money, you worried about your sister and your brother's gift. What they got, trying to compare, you know, because kids do that all the time. They try to compare the love. When your mother and father loves all of you, and they look at the size, well, that bike's bigger than this little doll. Yeah, but that bike is what he wanted. That doll is what you wanted. Hallelujah. But you got so much envy in your eyes, you can't see the importance of your gift. You know, like people and saints of God today. Hallelujah. They're worried about their sister and brother's gift. Hallelujah. What they have. Hallelujah. They forget what God done gave them.
Amen.
They forget the potential, hallelujah, of their gift. God can't even bring it out. God can't even use you. God can't even bring it out. Hallelujah, because you're too envy and jealous of your sister and brother. You always got an attitude thinking you're the greatest, thinking you can sing the best, you can preach the best, you can pray the best. You ought to sit down somewhere and ask God for some more grace. You need some more grace to humble your behind down, to appreciate the gift that God gave you. Hallelujah. They're worried about your sister and brother's gift. Envy of your sister and brother. What about the gift that God gave you? Hallelujah. When you look in the face of God, you look at Jesus. Jesus, hallelujah, was presented, hallelujah, by God on Christmas Day. Hallelujah. He gave his greatest gift. The greatest gift was the love of Jesus, his only begotten son. But we don't appreciate Jesus. We put up Buddha and Allah. We put up Virgin Mary. Forget about Virgin Mary. I'm going to serve the creature and not the creator. I'm going to serve the creator and not the creature. I forget about Virgin Mary and concentrate on baby Jesus. We cry all the day long. Hallelujah. And we go out with our hard-earned money. And we go get these gifts for these children. And then they got a nerve to say, I don't want it. I'm going to take it back. How selfish are you? Hallelujah. How selfish are you that you want to take back what I gave you from my heart? Spent 3 hours in the mall with my hurt leg looking up and down, especially for you. That gift, you unappreciated, unadulterated, selfish heathen. You ought to appreciate the gift of God. Whatever God gave you, you need to appreciate it. Some people don't have legs, don't have feet, don't have water, don't have food. Never mind a present. Hallelujah, forget that. They looking for some air. Go find me some air. We looking for some air. So many people with oxygen tanks don't have no air. You got air to breathe. You got lungs to hold air. Some people are born without lungs. Hallelujah, they gotta use a plastic lung. Hallelujah, you gotta use an oxygen tank. You are ungrateful heathens. You are ungrateful heathens. You are the thank God for everything that you get. Hallelujah. Because mama could be dead, sleeping in her grave. Who would take care of you? Who would feed you? Who would pay them bills? Who would pray for you? Who would baptize you? Who would tell you, I love you in spite of everything that you do? Now you take that to the bank. And you deposit it.
Amen.
Because if Moses didn't grab him by the tail, he wouldn't know how powerful God was. God said, grab the snake by the tail. Hallelujah. When he grabbed it, it turned into the rod and staff. They comfort me in the presence of my enemy. I have nothing to fear. Hallelujah. I got my rod. Grab it, church. Grab your rod. Grab it, church. Grab your rod. And watch what? Watch God do miracles. Watch him do miracles. Everything you need, you just say it. Claim it. Say it. Claim it. That settles it. God has all the power. God has all the power. I don't care what it is. He got all the joy. He got all the love. He got all the peace. We worry about stupid stuff. We worry about stupid stuff. God talked to me real good 3 o'clock this morning. He said sometimes we worry about too much money. Let me tell your stupid, silly self something. Money ain't gonna get you into heaven, but it'll sure put you in hell.
Come on, come on.
Did you hear me? Money ain't gonna get you to heaven, but it'll sure put you in hell. You better make it to your way. You better make it your way to God on Sunday morning. You better stop your foolish thinking. You better stop your foolish gesture. You better stop your foolish ways and make it your way to church on Sunday. Because Sunday, Sunday, Sunday is God's holy day. And it's a blessing and a miracle waiting for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, it is. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. How often do we put our portion to only see another man's portion? How often are our blessings or source, hallelujah, blinded by wandering eyes? What does God think about this? Hallelujah. When our eyes wander to another portion, we miss the delight of our own. We don't miss the joy of getting a gift our own. I give you, Sister Jessica, a blouse, and I give Sister Drina maybe a scarf.
To the best of my ability.
Sister Drina looks at her dress and say, wow, that's a beautiful dress. I should have got that. I've been here longer than her. She just got here. What am I doing getting a scarf?
I wouldn't do that.
Hallelujah. But we laughing. But that's the way we are. We laughing. But we know we thinking in our heart. Why did she get that dress? She only here a hot minute. I've been here 10 hours. Hallelujah. I've been here all my life. She just hopped in here. But God loved her just as much as she loved you. God loved you, honey, just as much as anybody in here. It's not the time that you spend. It's when you get up in here on Sunday morning and you are blessed on Sunday morning. Miracles are coming your way. Healing is coming your way on Sunday morning. You can bless God and he can bless you on Sunday morning. That's what I'm talking about.
Preach, Bishop!
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. We missed the joy. It didn't already took off. The anticipation of the Thanksgiving, the appreciation, the purpose, the passion, and the moment. We don't miss the moment of all the gratefulness, of all the thanksgiving, of all the passion that they thought of this gift. We don't miss the purpose. We don't miss the moment. You need to seize the moment.
Got that right.
Amen. Hallelujah. You need to seize the moment. Like him, we are worried about getting what we missed. Hallelujah. Like him, we are so worried about getting that we miss what God is giving. Did you get it?
Amen.
Like him, we are so worried about getting that we miss what God is giving. Yeah. Let's be changed this attitude. Yeah. Let's change our attitude.
Amen.
And start enjoying what the Lord has placed before us.
Amen.
Stop being envy and jealous. You husbands and wives, stop being jealous of one another. Just because God made me, hallelujah, a doctor and didn't make you nothing. Well, what are you doing?
All right now.
Just because God made you an evangelist and he didn't make me evangelist. Well, what are you doing?
Uh-oh. That's the question.
Come on with it, Bishop.
Just because God made you a minister and didn't make you a minister. But what are you doing? We wanna be so great to jump in somebody's shoes and ain't never did no work. We must be so grateful to jump in somebody's shoes and ain't never suffered a day. I've been suffering for 3 months with this knee. Hallelujah. You know this knee don't hurt on Sunday morning. It don't never act up. But you let it come Monday. That knee be cramped up, buckled up, stiff, can't move. God say, lay in the bed and go somewhere and sit down.
Amen.
That's what he want me to do. That's what he want me to do.
Yes.
But these devils don't want me to do that. These devils don't want me to do that. They want to work the hell out me. And I ain't talking about my children. Because my children are sweet boys. My children are sweet. They don't like me to say boys. My son, sweet young men. Hallelujah. But the devil don't want me to do that. Let me tell you a little bit about the devil. The devil want me to cramp up, stiff up. Hallelujah. But you know, I'm not a woman to sit still. I will preach if I got to do it in a wheelchair. I will preach, hallelujah, if I got to crawl on this floor. Hallelujah. I will preach, hallelujah, if I'm sitting down in a chair and you got to hold a mic. Hallelujah. Because I let nothing separate me. I'm not like you heathens. I'm not waiting for somebody to prop me up. I'm not waiting for somebody to carry me in. I'm not waiting for somebody to give me a cane. God is my cane. God is everything to me. I let nothing separate me from his love. Hallelujah. People of God, stop being envious. Stop being jealous of everybody, your stupid self. Oh, don't buy him no suit. Oh, don't buy her no dress. You better shut up somewhere. Tell me what to do. I'll tell you off. I buy what I want to buy. When I want to buy. Don't muzzle the ox, the thread is out the corn.
Right.
I work hard for my money.
All right, Bishop.
I preach hard.
I like
it. I pray
Bishop.
For your heart.
I
go fast. I almost passed out in the store.
Oh, come on.
Yes, sweat popping off me, Miles Jr. I had to grab a water bottle. I'm laughing now because it's funny. I'm laughing now because it's funny. But then it wasn't funny. I thought I was dying. So I told the Lord, I said, Lord, if you're going to take me now, let me get a present out Sunday morning, and then you can take me.
That's what she said.
That's how I felt.
That's what she said.
I told her my Bible said, that's how I felt. My dude, sweat popping with me like that. Big old drops of sweat. Standing in that line, waiting for you to get them gifts wrapped. Woo! Standing in that line, leg hurting like I don't know what. Had walked all over the mall. You know, Providence Mall is big.
Oh,
who you go with?
Nobody. You don't go by myself. I do everything by myself.
Come on now.
I said, Lord. I drank the water and I sat down in the chair. I said, Lord, you're going to take me. Because I was fasting. I ain't told nobody I was fasting. For y'all old heathens. For y'all stiff necks. For y'all old jealous heathens. Jealous of nothing. This is a church of love. This ain't a church of hate. We love everybody. Stop being jealous. Stop being envy. Get in the right attitude. There ain't no church of that mess.
No.
We know how to love.
Yes, we do.
My father used to have this pulpit, his roster
filled
with thousands of gifts.
Because
everybody wouldn't get no one gift. Everybody would get five apiece.
Every year.
We would get five apiece. Huh. My son said, Mama, who all these gifts for? I said, you are like brand new. I've been doing this every 28 years. I've been doing it before you was born. They don't know. I've been giving ever since before they were born. All I know how to give. I sit in my house and cry. My sister called me and said, well, I ain't got no money. And I said, I ain't either. I said, and I started crying. I said, I got to get the church gift. When I finished crying, the end of the week, the money started pouring in.
Uh-huh.
I ran out, got the gifts.
Got that right.
Hallelujah. God don't mistake me. God don't mistake me for somebody else. He know who I am.
Amen.
He called me by my name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He knows my name. I don't care if it's bitten. I don't care if it's clock. He know who I am.
Yeah.
Come on, bitch. Yeah, she used bitten sometimes. She used clock. I know she is. Still my girl.
That's it.
Still my girl.
Amen.
She's still my girl. Come on in.
Come on in.
Hallelujah. Start enjoying the Lord placed before us. Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Matthew 6:26. Matthew 6:26. If the Lord wanted us to have more, we would have more. But we don't. We can't always know. We can't always tell. We can't always understand. But we understand that the Lord's ways are not our ways. He knows better than us. Faith is trusting no matter what things look like. If you say you trust God, no matter what it look like, trust Him.
That's right.
Just what you got to do. That's what you got to do. For our children, we don't realize that we already have a bigger blessing. The bigger, the better goods and the size and the portion, we have Christ. That's our gift. It's not the size of the gift, not how much you get. We have Christ. And my God will meet all your needs according to his riches and glories. Philippians 4:19. Let your eyes look directly forward and gaze straight before him. Proverbs 4:25. One pride will bring you low, but who is low in spirit will obtain honor. Proverbs 29:23. Take delight in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Psalms 37:4. He will provide you for your deepest need. He will Hallelujah. We can look high and we can look low, but God's gifts are fresh in our heart. God is strengthening our heart and our portions forever. Psalm 73:26. This is my last verse.
Amen.
It's not material blessings, but in material blessings that blow us away with joy. Did you get it?
Amen.
It's not material blessings, but immaterial blessings that blow us away with joy.
Yes.
When you receive the Holy Ghost,
yes,
that's when you have joy.
Amen.
Not these gifts.
Right.
When you're baptized in His name, that's when you have joy.
Amen.
Not these gifts. Hallelujah. I'm not saying it because I'm in need, for I have learned to be content whatever state I'm in.
Amen.
Philippians 4:11. Grab hold of God instead of material goods. Hallelujah. For true significance. Not having gives us the chance to have the greater gift. A gift that is filled with security and provides us security. What was once insecure becomes secure with Christ. Hallelujah. So we thank the Lord for the reading of God's word.
Hallelujah.
May it be a blessing unto your soul, heart, mind, and body.